Hi, these three devices are buck converters, and they make a great alternative to linear voltage regulators. In this video, I'll show you in practice why and when you should consider using buck converters. Linear voltage regulators, like this commonly used LM7805, are so cheap and so easy to use. Just supply those two pins with 7 to 16 volts. Add a 10 microfarad capacitor on the input. Another one on the output. And you get steady 5 volts. As we all know, nothing's perfect, and so are linear voltage regulators. They are quite inefficient because they waste energy and produce a lot of heat. How much heat, you may ask? Let's take an example. If you want to feed your voltage regulator with 9 volts and draw 500 milliamps on the output, you will have to dissipate 2 watts of heat. The temperature of your LM7805 will definitely go above 100 degrees Celsius or 212 degrees Fahrenheit. If you want to draw even more current or increase the input voltage, you might need a big heatsink or use a buck converter. Probably all computer power supplies utilize buck converter circuitry to maximize efficiency. You can buy buck converters in different shapes, sizes, and with different specifications. Another name for a buck converter is voltage step-down converter, which describes its purpose pretty well. You feed those two pads with DC voltage, and you get constant lower voltage here. The output voltage is adjusted by this potentiometer. For example, you can set it to 5 volts, and this little guy becomes a very efficient 5 volts voltage regulator. Let's compare in practice the already mentioned LM7805 linear voltage regulator with this really small buck converter. Both are given 12 volts on the input, and they provide 5 volts on the output. The driver boards from these old hard drives consume approximately 450 milliamps, and they will serve as my dummy load. I will measure the power consumption and temperature of the linear voltage regulator and the buck converter under the same load, 15 minutes after powering up. Only 2 minutes later, the LM7805 consumes about 420 milliamps at 12 volts. But as you can see, the power consumption drops to zero, and then goes back to 420 milliamps, over and over again. The LM7805 shuts down if the temperature goes too high. It can operate properly up to 125 degrees Celsius, or 257 degrees Fahrenheit. Then let's check the temperature. As you can see, it's well above the safe range, so the regulator shuts down and turns on after cooling down a bit. The linear voltage regulator draws 420 milliamps at 12 volts, which gives us 5.04 watts. Now let's check if the buck converter can finish the same test. After exactly 15 minutes, the buck converter draws only 220 milliamps at 12 volts, which is only 2.64 watts. In this configuration, the linear voltage regulator consumes over 90% more power than the buck converter, which is worth considering, especially when your device is battery powered. Now let's check the temperature. As you can see, the buck converter stays at only 38 degrees Celsius, or 100 degrees Fahrenheit. In this example, the superiority of the buck converter is very clear, but you can buy an LM7805 for about 30 cents, while the cheapest buck converter will cost you about $2.50. There is one more thing. Because buck converters use coils, they may cause interference in your circuits. So if you're building something sensitive like a radio, for example, you should grab a linear voltage regulator and live with all its drawbacks. On the other hand, when you are designing a device in a small enclosure where proper airflow cannot be provided, a linear voltage regulator with a big and hot heatsink is probably not a good idea. Now you know the main advantages and disadvantages of buck converters and linear voltage regulators. If you have any questions or want to add something, feel free to write a comment below, send me a message on Facebook, Twitter, or use a contact form on my website. If you find this comparison useful, you can support me by sharing this video with your friends, giving me a thumbs up, or subscribing to my channel. Thanks for watching and see you next time.